Almighty God, we have come to this place of worship to praise you and to glorify your holy name. But we have also come because we want to say thank you for everything that you have done for us. Almighty God, you have been good to us. You have given us life, and you have given us family and friends. But this morning we also come because some of us have burdens that they need to bring to you. So this morning, as we prepare to listen to your message, we ask you just to be present with us, just to surround us with your love and care. We ask you to hear our quiet prayers. We ask you to just accept us as we are, so Almighty God, this morning let all the words that are going to be said today be just acceptable to you. Let all the silent prayers that your people are making are also acceptable to you. We ask this in your name. Amen. A construction worker were laying down a drain line as part of a new building. And while excavating, the workers uncovered a power cable directly in part of their work. The excavation was halted. An electrician was called in. The electrician came and looked at the cable, and he assured the workers that the cable was dead. And he said to the crew, go ahead and cut it out of the way. The electrician told the workers that they should go on and remove it. But the four men intervened and said to this electrician, are you really, really sure there is no danger? Absolutely, was the reply. Then the foreman asked a question. Well, if you say everything is good, the cable is dead, then will you cut it for us and remove it out of the way? The electrician hesitated for a moment, then answered, "I'm not so sure." The title I chose this morning, Actions, speaks louder than words. I am not sure that I can do this. Last Sunday, I shared with the church about grace. And I shared with the church how disturbing the scriptures were. How workers were paid the same amount when they started their job at different hours. And I said to the church last Sunday, we are all equal. In God, there's no exceptions. God accepts us as we are. God doesn't have special people. And you remember last Sunday I said, even me, myself, I'm not really as special as I think I am. But God accepts each and every one as you are. Jesus talking to the Pharisees and the priests of his time. The priests and the Pharisees had a big problem. They asked too many questions and they wanted answers. This morning, they're asking a question. Who gave you this authority? Who gave you this power? They wanted to know. That is the question. Remember last time, the question was, how can I get into heaven? That was the question. And this morning, who gives you authority to do what you do? And Jesus says to the Pharisees again, yes, I will answer your question, but can you answer mine? Where did John the Baptist get the authority? Was it human origin? They knew it was a trap. They knew that people during Jesus' time respected John the Baptist. They thought John the Baptist was a prophet. If they said different, it would create riots. And their answer was, we do not know. Then Jesus comes with a parable again, two sons. Can you do this work for me? The other son said, yes, I will do. But did not. Will you do this work for me? The other son says, no. But changes his mind and does the work that the Father had asked. And Jesus asked the question again, who of these two people did the will of the Father? And they immediately answered, and they said, the the first one, who said no and then did the work. You see? And Jesus says something powerful that I want to bring to your attention this morning. The tax collectors and the prostitutes will enter the kingdom of heaven. My brothers and sisters, listen to this. Again, Jesus is repeating the same teaching. No one is special. Everybody is welcome. When you think you are number one, Jesus says, no, you are not number one. When you think you are the best, Jesus says, no, you're not the best. When you say, well, I'm the minister, Jesus says, no, you should be a servant. The Pharisees with blind. Sometimes, Strathroy United Church, we are blinded. We don't see what God is doing. The Pharisees are blinded. They don't see what God is doing in their midst. Sometimes in the church, we are blinded. We don't see what God is doing in Strathroy United Church because we ask too many questions. We don't see what God is doing. And friends, God is doing wonderful things in this congregation. Believe it or not, God is doing wonderful things. So I'm asking you this morning, let us not be blinded by little things like the Pharisees. Let's not be blinded. Let's open our eyes and see what God is doing. Ministry is happening in this church. People are being taken care of. People are loved. Yes. All the people who are ill, Lila sends the cards. Wonderful things are happening in this church. So let's not be blinded. This Thursday, once again, we fed about 92 people from our community. Ministry is happening. Things are happening in this church. Two people have signed up to pray for us. Bible study is happening. We have a grant for youth of this church. Sunday school is happening. David is video. Tina is controlling the mic. Things are happening in this church. I see myself on YouTube, then. Oh boy. I've never seen myself on YouTube. But now I can see myself on YouTube. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness. things are happening in this church. We might say they are gone, but I tell you, they are. This morning, one of our members said to me, Abiel, you remembered when I asked you to pray for people in Florida, and you prayed for them? My house is safe. Thank you for the prayer. Oh, people, things are happening in this church. So don't be blinded. Don't look at the negative stuff. Look at the positive stuff. Oh, boy. Sometimes, this is the second point I want to make. Our actions do not match our words. This is a tough one. We say things and we don't do it. We don't walk the walk or talk the walk, whatever it is. Now, I remember Julian. I was a teenage boy, lived, grew up in Soweto. Julia was my neighbor. She lived with her mom and stepfather. But there was something wrong with Julia. She never went to school. She never attended high school. During the day, she slept the whole day. But during the night, a black car with dark windows came, picked her up, and she was gone. She came back 8 hours of the morning. That was her job. People didn't like it. People in the neighborhood hated it, hated Julia. Then she got sick, and nobody visited Julia. Me and my friend Joseph would go in the morning to ask if she needed anything. She got sick and she died. So, when she died, a little committee was formed to prepare for the funeral. And I was one of those people because people in the neighborhood said, you talk with her a lot, you know much about her. I didn't know anything about her. Then we went around asking for money. Ultimately, we went to a grocery store, the only grocery store we had in the community. And as we entered the grocery store, the owner, we said to him, we are here for funds for Julia. The guy said, wait a minute. Went back to the office, came back with two ledgers. And in the ledger were names of people in the community who were buying groceries on credit. And this gentleman said to me and to Joseph, you see this list of people? The red is they all. The blue, it was pills. And he said, I don't know, you don't want to hear this. But this is what Julia did. Every month she would come to the grocery store and ask the grocery owner how many people are owing. And she would pay. speaks louder than words. She was a bad, bad, bad person, according to human standards. I believe in my heart that Julia is sitting nicely in heaven for the good things that she has done. Actions speak louder than our words. Now, as we say, we love to show it. I'm not ashamed of Strathroy United Church. In fact, I'm so proud. Now I'm known in town. Oh yes, that guy comes again. Oh, I'm the minister from Strathroy United Church. That's my mantra. I love this church. And I love these people. At the end of the service, I will invite you to go outside and read a new sign outside that the community life team has put. Love your neighbor. God does not have exceptions. We don't need. Tax collectors and prostitutes will get tired.